ITC is a household name in India. It's a well-diversified conglomerate which has an interesting range of products to offer. With more than 100 years of existence, ITC created a strong brand value and network across India. ITC covers different aspects of your life, from lighting agarbatti to smoking cigarette, from eating biscuits to making roti. ITC brand is everywhere. So in today's episode, let's understand how big is ITC. ITC was incorporated on August 24, 1910, under the name Imperial Tobacco Company of India Limited. Over the years, company's ownership shifted to Indians and the name of the company was changed to India Tobacco Company Limited in 1970 and then to ITC Limited with dots in between in 1974. But over the years, company has forayed into different businesses and was just not a tobacco company. So in recognition of that fact, full stops in the company's name were removed in 2001. The company now stands as ITC Limited, where ITC is today no longer an acronym. The company's beginnings were humble. A leased office on Radha Bazar Lane, Kolkata was the center of company's existence. The company celebrated its 16th birthday on August 24, 1926 by purchasing the plot of land in Chaurangi for 3,10,000 rupees. It was to mark the beginning of a long and eventful journey into India's future. The company's headquarters building, Virginia House, which was built on that plot of land 2 years later, would go on to become one of Kolkata's most famous landmarks. Initially, company was concentrating on growth and consolidation of cigarettes and leaf tobacco business. After that, ITC's packaging and printing business was set up in 1925 as a strategic backward integration for ITC's cigarettes business. ITC is the 13th largest publicly traded company in India with combined market capitalization of 2,49,561 crores. And 56% of Indian households consume some form of ITC's product every year. The whole economy of India can be divided into three sectors: agriculture or primary sector, manufacturing or secondary sector, services or tertiary sector. And ITC has its presence in all these sectors. Let's take a look at ITC's business lines. Since its creation, agriculture has always been central to ITC's business. Initially, to make cigarettes, company had to source the tobacco from farmers. So, the company created a separate division called ILTD or ITC's Leaf Tobacco Division. This business is almost 100 years old. ITC is the largest buyer, processor and exporter of leaf tobacco in India. Company buys nearly 50% of all cigarette tobacco grown in India, serving customers in 50 countries across more than 70 destinations. Over the years, company has created a huge network of farmers, so as an extension to its existing tobacco business, ITC has created agri-commodities and rural services business. Its business model is simple. ITC directly sources produce like wheat, rice, coffee, etc. from farmers in its network, uses some part of it for its products, and exports the remaining portion to different parts of India and other countries. ITC's agri business is country's second largest exporter of agri products. As the company already have a huge network of farmers across India, the company started its eChaupal initiative. ITC has provided computers and internet access in rural areas across several agricultural regions of the country, where the farmers can directly negotiate the sale of their product with ITC Limited. Online access enables farmers to obtain information on mandi prices and good farming practices, and to place orders for agricultural inputs like seeds and fertilizers. With its expertise in agriculture, company provides food safety and R&D services to other businesses through its division ITC Analytics. FMCG segment is something that ITC is known for. This segment contributes to 65% of company's revenues and 87% of company's profit. ITC has a vast range of popular FMCG products, and majority of which you already know. Let's start with the food segment. ITC's Ashirvad brand is known for its atta and is a market leader in this segment. Apart from atta, company also sells ghee, salt, spices, ready-to-eat meals and instant mixes under this brand. With popularity in households, Ashirvad became an independent brand. ITC has a strong presence in biscuits market under Sunfeast brand like Glucose Biscuits, Mom's Magic and Dark Fantasy. Through its bingo range of potato chips and finger snacks, company directly competes with Lay's and ITC is the second largest player in this segment. With its Yippie noodles, company is the second largest player in instant noodles and pasta segment, followed by Maggi in the first place. ITC also operates in juices and beverages segment with Be Natural brand. Under confectionery segment, company has Minto and Candyman range of candies and Gum On chewing gum. Apart from these products, company offers luxury chocolates under Feeble brand, coffee under Sunbean brand, authentic Indian chutneys and masalas under Kitchens of India brand, dairy beverages under Wonders Milk brand, frozen snacks and vegetables under the brand MasterChef and Farmland. Interesting fact, the famous oil brand Sundrop was once owned by ITC, but in 2013, company sold its edible oils division to ConAgra Foods to concentrate more on its tobacco business. By the way, if you are enjoying this video, consider subscribing to my channel. Under personal care segment, company has Savlon brand, which provides a range of antibacterial products. Especially during the pandemic, Savlon has seen spike in demand for its products. In body care segment, company has Fiamma, Vivil, Superior brands. Company sells deodorants under Engage brand and is the second largest player in this segment. Apart from other brands, company owns Shower to Shower, Nimail, Essence Edibles and Charmis. Under stationery segment, company has two sub-brands, Classmate and Papercraft. Classmate is India's number one stationery brand, whereas Papercraft offers premium notebooks and pens. Company also owns famous Agarbatti brand Mangaldeep. Apart from these brands, company sells matchboxes, cloths, dishwashing gel, vegetable and fruit washing liquids. By now, you must have understood how diversified company's product portfolio is. But all the FMCG products we discussed so far accounts for just 3% of company's total profit. And the remaining 84% profit comes from just one product, and that is cigarette. ITC is the market leader in cigarettes business in India with more than 100 years of expertise in developing products to match the evolving taste of consumers. ITC has a wide range of brands including Classic, Goldflake, Berkeley, Bristol, Flake, Silk Cut, Duke and Royal. ITC's large network of farmers and strong supply chain helps in sourcing the best quality tobacco. Not only in India, company also sells cigarettes in other countries as well. ITC is the third largest player in Bahrain and Qatar. Company also manufactures paper, paperboards and packaging material, and ITC is the market leader in this segment. ITC entered into hotels business in 1975. It is India's premier chain of luxury hotels. It operates under 4 hotel chains with more than 100 hotels over 70 destinations. ITC Hotels has set a new standards of excellence in the industry. Apart from the above services, company also provides software services through its ITC Infotech. Interesting fact, ITC once had an NBFC under the name ITC Classic, but due to piling up bad debts and allegations of fraud, this company was later sold to ICICI Bank in 1996. In terms of sustainability, ITC is far ahead of its competitors. Company is carbon positive for the last 15 years, water positive for the last 18 years, solid water recycling positive for last 13 years, and 41% of company's energy consumption comes from renewable sources. While ITC's business is doing great, its stock price is not going anywhere. ITC stock hit all-time high of 354 in July 2017. And after that, stock was never able to reach that high and currently trading at around 200 rupees. While the fundamentals are great for the company, market sentiment is really bad. Reason? ITC's tobacco business. 84% of company's profits come from tobacco business and it falls under the category of sin products which are taxed at a high rate by Indian government. ITC's higher dependence on tobacco business is impacting the investor sentiment negatively. Even mutual funds are reducing their stake in companies that are selling sin products. But the company is trying to change this image. It is expanding its business in the FMCG space. Although FMCG segment is contributing a small portion to its profits, it is the fastest growing segment. Cigarette business is a cash cow for ITC. Company can earn millions from cigarettes business without spending heavily on marketing. But will ITC be ready to forego its evergreen business? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. So that's the video, guys. If you like my content, consider subscribing to my channel. And don't forget to smash that bell icon to be notified every time I release a new video. Thanks for watching. This is Curious Monk, signing off.